Get the 16,000 or so.
Oh, the 16,000 petitions, or signatures on the petitions. Well, they haven't gone under the charter. Our charter provides for proposing ordinances or proposing charter amendments. They haven't proposed either one of those on the petition. And the state has a procedure for proposing charter amendments, is missing the charters. They have not traveled, they're not proposing a charter amendment. By law, there is no procedure by which they are traveling to get something on the ballot. There is no law that I know of that allows you to put a straw vote on, petition to put a straw vote on the ballot. That, having said that, it becomes a political question of what you want to do if they do get to 16,000. Do you want to put it on the ballot? Are you going to put it on the ballot? I don't think there's any time frame that would require you to put it on the ballot, as was indicated. However, with this process, this ongoing process, obviously you want it on the ballot as soon as you could if they get the signature. If you plan to again, it's a straw poll, you won't be bound by it, but if you plan to be influenced by it, whether or not you go forward by vote, you'd want it as soon as possible. You cannot, if you decide to put it on the ballot, you cannot do a campaign one way or the other to influence the vote. You can put out facts. You can put your own questions on the ballot. Are you willing to, you know, have your millage increase for 2 years by 1 mil to pay for the difference it's going to cost you to do that? You could do that. You could say, are you willing to pay quarter of a mil a year for the maintenance of this structure as opposed to whatever it would be or something less? Appear to subsidize. And yes, it is subsidized. To have retail out there of any scale, you will be subsidizing the retail.
Okay.
To have no retail, you will still be subsidizing the retail.
I just wanted to understand
there's no
legal situation.
There is no legal obligation for you to put it on the ballot because they have not traveled under any of the our charter or the laws with respect to putting it on the ballot. That you've already indicated sort of informally that you want to put it on the ballot.
I will say I think the gravest error we made with this was showing people the $150 million version, and then having to, sort of wind it back down. I will say that I think the greatest opportunity we have is that we really have a huge waterfront park that's surrounded by water on all sides that we use as a parking lot, and with candidly not a great deal more than grass and some trees, you could have a great waterfront park. I mean, it wouldn't have to be just a Vinoy or a Straub where you had big events. And it's a prettier view, but it's water all around you. And so as we continue this thing, I think there's an opportunity there at a very modest price. So I guess that's kind of the angst I'm feeling. I'll stop there.
Thank you. Councilmember Curtis.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just a couple of things before I... At the end of the basis of design phase, there is a list of deliverables.